Hi, I'm Mikey.
I'm Tasha.
You're watching Mobo TV.
The Mobo TV.
Mobo TV.
Mobo TV. Keep watching.
What's going on, guys? You're watching Mobo TV. I'm Tasha, and today we're joined by the lovely Yasmin. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Okay, so 2011 was a crazy busy year for you. Can you pick out your one stand-up moment?
I always get asked that. It's quite hard to pick one moment. You know, the whole year was a highlight, and you know, I could never have imagined I would have had like two top 40 singles, and I was nominated for Mobo. I presented a Mobo, and I got to just do some fantastic shows, and I supported Snoop Dogg, I supported Chasing Status. Like, the whole year, I just think it's so hard to pick one moment. The whole year was one big moment, I think.
Sounds crazy. People were first made aware of you singing vocally on Devlin's track, Runaway. How did that collab come about? Because it wasn't like you were singing before.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've been kind of doing stuff behind the scenes, and I was doing a lot of writing. It was when I just started kind of going in, doing sessions, and I've worked a lot with producers called Future Cut, who are responsible for like Rich, Unorthodox, a lot of Lily Allen, Dizzy Rascal, and I was actually just round the corner from their studio one day, and I gave them a call, and I was like, should I come up and say hi? And they were like, yeah, we've got Devlin in, but he's just gone for lunch, like, come up and hang out. So I jumped up, and while I was there, I was chatting with the guys, Devlin came back, and they played me what they'd been working on, and it was Runaway. It had no chorus on it. And there was a little space that they'd left for the chorus, and I said, I don't want to intrude, but I've got a little idea, do you like it? And I sang it for them and they loved it, so ended up being his second single. That was so much fun. It's a really nice way to kind of get, you know, introduced to everyone, and you know, it is a beautiful song and it's really heartfelt, and that's the thing about Devlin, his lyrics are just incredible. And yeah.
Wow, nice little sneak in there. Don't ask if you don't get. And you did Young Guns as well with Devlin, Criminal Gets. What was that like? That was a really, really good track, but again, slightly different to what you've done. Not Gets, Ed Sheeran, wasn't it?
Well, Young Guns, myself, Criminal, Devlin and Ed Sheeran, we all did a photo shoot for ID Magazine, and it was a kind of like ones to watch, up and coming, blah, 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 blah. And after the shoot, we were all like, let's go to the studio. Let's, you know, we're all here. We're around the corner from the studio. Let's just go. So we did, went in the studio with Louis White, and we just started making this song, and we loved the fact that we were all kind of young and doing our thing, and we're all very individual, and that's where the kind of concept of Young Guns came about. And you know, all the guys smashed it, you know, we all kind of wrote our individual parts, and it was nice that we got to do a video and got a little release and everything, and it was just a fun collaboration. There was no kind of expectation with it, no trying to be anything else, it just happened, and it was fun.
So your first single did really well, debuted in the top 40. Did you ever imagine your first single to do that well? Was you apprehensive at how it was going to get taken?
I mean, you can never expect anything. I think when you release a single, you have to just be open to however people connect to it or interpret it. And you know, I grew up listening to the top 40 chart as a kid. You know, I used to tape it, and so I think just to be in it was quite a big achievement, and it was really exciting. And you know, like, I signed independently because it felt like the right thing for me. You know, and there's a lot of challenges that come with that, but I wouldn't change it for the world. It's the right. It's my journey, and it's my way to go.
Good. And you worked with Labyrinth for Finish Line. What was it like working with him?
Labyrinth is a musical genius. He's like a madman, and you go in the studio and he's jumping from the keys to the guitar to the bass, like to the mic, everything. He's just involved, and it's like when he's creating, it's like he's on a different kind of level of consciousness than the rest of us are, and he's just really inspiring. And when I work with Labyrinth, I always feel like he brings out the best in me, because I just feel like I'm in the studio trying to be on his level. So it's always, you know, the times we've been in the studio, we've always got something fantastic. So he's incredible.
He is amazing. And now your latest single, Light of the World, produced by ShyFX and Miss Dynamite. How was it working with Miss Dynamite? How did it come along getting her on the track?
Well, me and Shy made the track originally, and you know, I've been in the studio a lot. It was throughout the summer, and it was kind of like, all right, after Finish Line, what do I want to say? What's the next single from me? What do I want to show everyone? And I kind of felt I hadn't really put across that side of me that has come from that club background and come from that underground kind of situation. And you know, me and Shy work well together. I just went into studio and I said, look, I don't want to try hard to do anything. I said, just give me a break beat and give me some reggae. And he kind of just threw it all together, made this track, we wrote it, vocaled it, he sent me the demo, and I just listened to it every single day. I was like, I love it, I love it, I love it. And we were both kind of like, it's amazing, but we feel it could be even better. And we instantly both thought of Miss Dynamite, and we gave her a call, and she loved the track and she was up for it. And she came down and just absolutely smashed it. And you know, she's an icon. She's as far as, you know, UK music and underground music go and mainstream, for the female, she's the one that we, you know, she's the poster child for that. She did that, and she's been so consistent, and she's still just putting out banger after banger. And just to kind of have her on the track and have her kind of bless it was amazing.
It's really, really good track, and the video looks amazing. Shot in Cuba, wish I was there with you. So how did it feel getting nominated for the MAVA Award this year?
It was amazing. It's my first kind of award I've ever been nominated for, and you know, the MOBAs is something I've grown up watching, and I was just really honoured, and the calibre of artists in the category were incredible. You know, I was in such great company, and I was just really, really honoured to be nominated.
And you presented an award as well?
I did. Everyone always said to me after that, they were like, oh, I never knew you were so tall. And I said, it's because I was like presenting an award with Adam Deacon, too tinchy and dappy, like the three shortest guys. And I was wearing some high heels. So I'm not that tall, but just taller than all of them.
So how do you work as an artist? What comes first for you? How do you make your music?
I don't really have a formula. Every time is different, and with a lot of my writing, I usually listen to hear a track or some chords, or sometimes just a plain beat, and I'll get a melody, and that's usually where it starts, is a melody. And then, you know, I'll kind of, 9 times out of 10 for me, the idea just comes, like it just pours out of my head into the melody and starts making sense. And I kind of think, like Amy Winehouse, she would say like songs write themselves, and sometimes I feel like they really do, because sometimes nothing is there, there's nothing to write, and it's really frustrating, but when it happens, and that's why it's so magical, because you can't, you know, if everyone could contain it and sell it on, then we'd all be writing amazing songs every day, but the magic is that it happens when it happens.
So what's next for Yasmin? What can we expect? The album?
Yes, definitely. The single's out January 15th, and I'm just working on the album, writing away, and I'm just going to keep writing until I've said everything that I feel like I need to say on this record. And I've done some acoustic sessions I'm really proud of, really excited about, that they're going to be kind of released, you know, over the course of the next couple months. I've got a show February the 15th, my first headline show for HMV's Next Big Thing. It's at the Borderline. Sway's going to be joining me as well. And yeah, just more music, more shows, and lots more fun.
Okay, so just to finish off, I've got a few random questions. Nando's or Wagamama's?
Nando's.
Okay, and if you lived in a man's body for the day, what would you do?
Pee standing up.
Which UK artist would you pick as Prime Minister and why?
Wow, who would I pick for Prime Minister and why? I would have to say Wiley, just because I think it would be just hilarious. I think he would just keep us all entertained, so Wiley.
You'd never know what's next, would you? What is Yasmin's piece of golden advice?
My piece of golden advice is just be yourself and never apologise for it. You know, be strong and know your worth and know what you deserve.
And where can everybody catch you at home? You got Twitters or website?
My website is www.yasminsworld.co.uk. You can follow me on my Twitter at It's Yasmin, Facebook Yasmin Online, and you know, if you go on the site, there's links to everything there, so you can find me
everywhere. And remember to go and get Light Up the World on January the 15th. And you've been watching Mobo TV, and you can check out mobo.com for the rest of the interviews.